If nachos and hamburgers and high school football are your thing, then Liberal, Missouri was the place to be. Liberal hosting the Pierce City Eagles as the Bulldogs band plays some sweet tunes. The crowd looks to spur their team to a victory this week. Pick things up in the first quarter. Pierce City quarterback Cole Kelly takes a snap, counters to the right, then runs back left, sprinting down the opposite sideline before powering his way in for the 40-yard touchdown. Skip ahead to the 54 seconds left in the first. Bulldogs have fourth and long at their own 30-yard line. They try the fake punt. Austin Johnston passes intercepted. He takes it in for the second Eagles touchdown of the night. Bulldog faithful desperately looking for something to cheer for. Next, Eagles possessing the ball inside. The one fullback, Mike Vincent, takes the handoff and scores another Eagle touchdown. A lack of success loses the attention of the younger crowd as the Pierce City Eagles win 55-30.
A fair number of ghouls and Sasquatch came out tonight to support the hometown Owls as they took on the Panthers. First drive of the game, Barnsdall quarterback James Cole takes a snap and looks deep for wide receiver Josiah Gott, who makes the uncontested catch and runs it in for the 42-yard touchdown catch. Riddle me this, Batman. What would the Panthers do next? Next Panther possession, Cole takes a snap. He's going to hand the ball off to running back Ethan Shaw, who breaks to the outside and shakes off the tackler like Taylor Swift before running in for the...
Oh, man.
He did it.
Soon.
He did it. Girl from the ring is looking even sicker than normal after that score. Panthers still up 12-0 with the ball. Second goal from the 5. Cole gathers on a snap. Once again, hands to Shaw, who gets to the edge of the Owl defense and easily goes in for his second score of the game. Even Scooby-Doo had a hard time, don't do that, watching this one as Barnsdall went on to win 48-0.
The cold temperatures didn't keep the diehard Wildcat fans from seeing their team play foil tonight. Midway through the third, Wildcats up 20-6. Wildcat quarterback Joe Baker hands the ball to running back Cole Hurley, who runs it in for a 5-yard touchdown. And as the cheerleaders excited next to the foil possession, whatever that was, is that a goat? Is that a goat? Anyway, the ball for the Cats. It's so cold he doesn't even celebrate, neither do the fans. This girl's as impressed as Michaela Maroney. The Wildcats wouldn't be able to add to their lead, though, as they have their own fumble of a few plays later. Following the Panthers' possession, Cordero Schroeder getting the block. This kick, which tricked out bounds for the safety. This young man just can't get a grip as the Wildcats win 36-12.
In the third place game in the boys' black racket, Neosho taking on the Morrilton Devil Dogs. First quarter, Wildcats down 2-0. Chris Lee knocks away the inbounds pass. Logan Stewart gives it right back. Lee finishes strong. Neosho ties this one up at 2. A few minutes later, it's Lee again. This time he's going to hit the pull-up jumper from the left elbow. Low scoring first quarter. After 1, Neosho only up 7-6. Second quarter, Devin Hames with the nice reverse layup for the Wildcats puts his team on top by 3. We move to under 10 seconds left in the first half now. Neosho by 7. Keyshawn Wright going to hit a deep ball just as time expires. Morrilton goes into half only down by 4. Second half, it was all Dogs. Chavez Zachary going to cut through the defense, give Morrilton the lead. The Devil Dogs opened up the third quarter on a 15-0 run. Neosho drops the third place matchup 41-25. And in the final game of the tournament, East Newton squaring off with Carthage in the championship game. First quarter, Carthage up 6-3 and adding to it. Alex Derryberry passes in to Garrett McAtee. He dishes it to Jesse Martini, who lays it up and in. Tigers have an early 5-point lead. But on the other end, the big man goes to work for the Patriots. Bryce Zimmerman gets it on the block, backs his way in, gets the shot to go down. East Newton pulls back to within 3. Second quarter, Carthage only up by 2 now. Zimmerman gives it off to Deion Clark in the corner. He's going to find the bottom of the bucket. Patriots grab a 1-point lead, but the Tigers answer right back on the other side. More nice interior passing from the big guys. Derryberry gives it into McAtee to Martini. He goes up strong for 2. It was a back-and-forth game, but in the end, the Patriots win at 56-49.
We'll start things off with the boys. 4:20 left in the first half. Buffalo ball down 7. Coleman Scott knocks the ball away. He's going to track it down, go in for the difficult layup. Bison coach Neil Welch implores his team to start playing smarter. Later, the Wildcats up 9 when Caden Hendricks feeds the ball inside to Michael Merriman. Spins, gets fouled, but he finishes strong with the left hand. He would miss the free throw. The mascot still danced because he appreciates what he's seeing. Fast forward to the second half. Bison down 38-21 when Lane Shelton pulls down the tough rebound, finds his teammate Rhett Kilgore streaking up the court. He lays in the basketball. These moms are not impressed, though. They're too busy pinning recipes on Pinterest. It would be all Wildcats from there. Neosho goes on to win the first round matchup 72-59. Moving on to the girls' action, the Lady Wildcats taking on Providence Academy. Early in the first quarter, Chelsea Henry pulls down the rebound. She's going to go coast to coast for the easy layup. Put the Wildcats up 5-3. Next Wildcat possession, Neosho puts on a ball movement clinic before getting the ball to Henry in the middle. She turns and nails the jumper. And this young fan looks surprised, but he shouldn't be. Emily Schell for Providence decides she's had enough of the press, takes a long pass in for the layup. It's okay, coach. Your girls are only down 5. In the second quarter, Melanie Matkins takes the pass, buries the 3 from the wing. In the end, it would be the Wildcats who come away with the win.
The Southeast Lancers had a disappointing year in 2013, finishing under 500 and missing the playoffs for the third straight season. Head coach Jared Hansen is entering his first season with the Lancers. He says the players have a good attitude going into 2014 and have put a lot of work in the offseason.
We've had a lot of kids show up for the summer weights and a lot of different camps and stuff like that, and we've had probably on average about 40 or 50 in the weight room. For the most part, their improvement has been dramatic. I mean, we've gotten kids that have increased on their maxes by 20 or 30 pounds apiece.